this grammar is a famous grammar. This is your all arithmetic expression. It is called the expression grammar. I've repeatedly told you. So here, what is the first of this grammar? First of the grammar, E plus E. And here it you have E study and no T. So from there, we derive this grammar E to E plus T slash T. Why T? We want to prioritize the multiplication operation than plus. If we go for E plus E or for this E, and here also we don't need this rule, then the problem will be in any string, there will be no order. So we know very well that multiplication has overriding than plus. To make it happen, we add this rule T is equal to T star F, so that we can all multiplication should be done first, as in our arithmetic expression. So this is you call a very good expression grammar formality for any programming languages with infix notation. It is the infix, and why you go for this extra T? Because we want to prioritize. So this is called very expression grammar, but this is not good for LL1 parsing. Why? Because the problem will be left recursion. See here, it left hand side E, also right hand side E. So here also T, here start with C. So both these rule violates top down parsing. Basic rule is first the grammar should be unambiguous. Grammar is unambiguous, no issue. But grammar contains the problem with the left recursion. Left recursion is absolutely no for top-down parsing. So we have to convert it. But this is good for bottom-up parsing. So later on, we'll do it for bottom-up parsing. We'll see bottom-up parsing, LR1 parsing can take more varieties of the grammar. Ultimately, all our programming languages run by bottom-up parsing, LR1 parsing. But to understand bottom-up parsing, we have to understand top-down parsing, because which discovered earlier, and then we'll go for bottom-up parsing. So our learning should be from the top-down parsing. From top-down parsing, we eliminate the undeterministic brute force techniques, because the problem will be back and forth. There you have an inordinate amount of time complexity, space complexity. But if we maintain the two rules just we mentioned there, it is unambiguous grammar, and right hand side of all expression with the first all should be shy, and any variable goes to epsilon, then first and follow intersection will be shy. Then, and if we can a parsing table, and rows will be variables and columns will be terminals, every box should have only one rule or no rule, so that is a deterministic predictive parsing. No backtrack, and we can rightly show you today with example, with a simple stack, with a top-down parsing, with a parsing table, we can parse any string. But this is, we cannot, the reason is, problem is, here the left recursion is not eliminated, so we have to remove by left recursion. How to remove? Let's see. So this is the original grammar. If you remove the left recursion, the grammar will be look like this, and we have some extra E dash and T dash. So grammar will be, here we have how many rules? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rules. Here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Extra 2 rules for, we have to remove left recursion of E and left recursion of T. We have to incorporate another E dash and T dash. So we have extra rules. So this is now, you can see this is now, no left recursion is there. So this is good enough for top-down parsing. So by the same rule, we have to calculate or fast and follow and arrange a parsing table and parse a sample string. Let's see. Next screen, yes, we can see it here. Yeah, you can see it here. This is the parsing table. For your reference, this is the original grammar, expression grammar. And this is, we remove the left recursion, we come here. And then we calculate the all first. Here you see, instead of S, the A, here the S is E, capital E. So grammar starts with capital E instead of S earlier. So we have first calculation here, first of E, definitely first of E will be first of T, and first of F. So we can come up here and then follow E, see follow of E, always a dollar, and also E, end of a parenthesis. How it is coming? Follow, because if you see it here, see here in this rule, E right hand side is closing parenthesis, so it goes to follow of E. So follow of E consists of a dollar, it's the end of, and then is a this parenthesis. So first calculate the first of E will be first of T will be first of F will be forward exclamation, this opening brace. So first of E is opening brace, and by this rule IND. So first of E is opening brace and IND. Now you calculate first of T dash. See, first of T dash is a star. So first of E star, because T dash goes to epsilon, star, comma, or here the comma is not in epsilon. Then first of E dash is plus. First of E dash is plus, because E dash can go to epsilon, so epsilon. Now follow of E, start symbol here, follow of E. So because start, always you put dollar. And from here you can see, after E, closing parenthesis, so dollar, comma, then follow of T. What should be the follow of T? The start of E dash. See here, follow of T, start of E dash, first of E dash. First of E dash is plus epsilon, epsilon cannot be there, plus, and E dash can be at the end, so dollar is there. So, and follow of T, where is follow? Follow of T will be first of E dash, plus should be there, definitely. And because T dash can be in, so it's a dollar can be there. So, we calculate first and follow. And any variable, so another, remember in my first exercise, I wish to tell you that you may, another table you should maintain by the same table, whether the variable is nullable or not. Here they have not. I wish you always do the practice. I'll make a note there, I'll make a practice. So here, which variable can be nullable? E dash can be nullable, and T dash can be nullable. So we also see first of E dash. First of E dash plus E, and follow of E dash, first of E dash, follow of E dash, here the bit you have not done, but I will check it. You know, I've already checked it that there will be no common characters. So I'll, what is it? Follow of E dash, dollar. So first of E dash and follow of E dash, no common character. And then we go for which variable can go to epsilon, T dash and E dash. E dash can go to epsilon, so we have to check. First of E dash and follow of E dash. First of E dash here plus, and follow of E dash is plus. First of E dash is plus, follow of E dash. What can be the follow of E dash? Follow of E dash, dollar definitely, because at the end. Epsilon, follow of E dash dollar definitely. Yes, so here also you see first of E dash plus, and follow doesn't contain plus. Are you sure? You please check this, because otherwise it is not possible. So there should be intersection. So next slide. Now we have this parsing table. This is the grammar, this is after left recursion, this is, we calculate first and follow, but here you definitely do, for all variables which are go to epsilon, you have to say whether nullable or not nullable. If nullable, you check that first of that variable and follow of that variable, intersection is shy. Now the same thing, this is one way, other way of saying. That is taking a too much whiteboard, so parsing stack, dollar should be at the end, and you have loaded with E here, here we have S, that is the star symbol, and this is the input string, and you have to predict from the parsing table. So, because I can see int here, and here E, so we go for E and int, so this is the rule, E to TE dash. So, we take out E and put TE dash, end of stack. But I have not consumed anything from here, because if I have to consume int, this is a terminal, this is not a variable, this is a terminal int plus a terminal, this is a plus terminal. I should match one int and this int, then I can take both. So here we have T and you can see int. So what is T int here? Here int is here. So this is the rule, TFT dash. So that is FT dash comes, E dash is even there, but your input is still int plus int, then you have to match, this is the top of the stack F, and this is INT, now see here F, INT, then now it good, the int comes. So now finally you got int, you take out F, put int, this int will be taken out, this will be taken out, so we'll have T dash, E dash, dollar, and your int is taken out. Actually, int in the string it is not taken out, only the pointer shifted. So, but from the stack it is taken out. From here it is taken out. And here, input, the pointer shifts. So, right now we have a plus, top of the, here the, from the left hand side, plus, and your top of stack is T dash. So, you can see it's T dash and plus, there is only one rule, T dash go to epsilon. So you just taken out T dash by the epsilon, T dash to epsilon. So right now the stack is E dash, and your input is plus int star, this is there. Okay, so now E dash to plus, you have to match. So E dash to plus, this rule, E dash to plus T dash. So here is a plus T dash comes, the plus T dash, and you have a plus. Now good thing, plus and plus matches, you can take it away. Actually it is not taken away, the pointer goes to this plus can be taken away, so T dash dollar, and now int star, you have to match this T with int, int, go to table, T, int, you have T, FT dash. Now you put FT dash. Taken out T, put FT dash here, E dash, and you have in, that int remains. Now you have to match F and INT. You can go there, see F and INT, good thing. Now this rule comes, so int int match. So I can int, I have taken out F, int, and here int, so I can take both. So I have T dash, E dash, dollar, and I have taken, actually I have not taken out, I have shift. Plus is there, plus int dollar. Now we have T dash and plus. Go to parsing table, T plus. So here T dash star FT dash. So put T dash T dash star FT dash E dash, and here star is good thing. Star and star matches. So you take it out of the stack, FT dash E dash, and you start. You have go another pointer, INT. Then you have to take F and INT. Now go for F and INT, you have that rule. Then another good thing, INT comes. So you put INT here, so we are end up. So we've taken out both. Now we have end of input, but your stack contains T dash and E dash, and you have very good rule. So T dash can go to epsilon, E dash can go to epsilon. Both consume T dash and E dash. Ultimately, your stack is empty, your input is empty, and success. So, that is it. So, we have done two examples, one with the whiteboard, and another is expression grammar. So, that's it. Any question?